I'm Zoha Mian from Kentucky Country Day.
Cool, man. High school. Basically, what we're going to talk about is healthy choices and how it affects every single person in here, regardless of the school. So basically, the whole idea is that, let's just think of a story for a second. So think of you're a young boy in high school, and you're due at 5:30, you've got your clothes, or you take a shower, you get, of course, a healthy breakfast, and then you head out to the bus, get on that bus, head to school, and you have rigorous courses throughout the day. You have pre-cal, chemistry, who knows? And of course, it's very, very tough, and you have tests, classwork, and then eventually, you get to lunch, and you're used, of course, to think, oh, great, I'm going to eat, you know, it's, of course, a great meal. Well, you go to the cafeteria, you see a, and you want it towards a healthy meal, but you also want a meal that tastes good and is appealing to you. Now, of course, you're looking at the title and say, we're tired of being number one, and you're getting older. What does that have to actually do with anything? I mean, who doesn't want to be number one? However, even though Kentucky is the 26th population, number one in child abuse. Now, that's a pretty shocking fact, considering that we have 4.4 million people in Kentucky. And that's a very small number compared to other states like California and Texas. And I think we're 3 million obesity, too. So, very high obesity, that's never good, of course. 80% of kindergartners, 24.2% of 6th graders until at least 5th reported obesity in 2012. It's a very recent statistic, about 4 years. And nothing probably has changed in that time. As you know, the farther you grow up in your life, your habits at a young age usually stick. And as you can see, the percentages, they get higher the older you get. That's the very good news. Basically, UCPS will fall short of its goal of 10% of home food. So 10% of the mass of food that UCPS gets will be open and grown. However, has fallen short in this year around 4%. So obviously the school year is already ending and we haven't even reached halfway. So that's obviously never good. And we need to fix that. That's what policy is for.
So who will this benefit? Firstly, it will benefit JCPS. Healthy food means attentive and happier students. This will increase desire for parents to enroll students in the JCPS system and will increase the reputation of JCPS. This will also help local food suppliers and local food farmers as it will increase the awareness of their local farms and will increase the local economy as we're buying local food. This will also help the students as they will benefit their future. Healthier and happier students will increase their self-esteem and will increase academic performance. And this will also help the parents. The parents talk to their children about health and they want a healthier lifestyle for their students as a whole. And this will benefit all of them together. So our recommendation. We are asking Metro Council to request that JCPS use the funding allocated to them by Metro Council to increase the amount of local food in JCPS cafeterias from 4% to 10% by 2020. Our envisioned outcome would be an increase in desire to eat healthier foods and an improvement in the well-being of students, resulting in improved academic performance and self-esteem. Greater awareness within JCPS families regarding healthy eating would result in an overall healthier diet and an overall increase in academic performance. We hope you consider our recommendation.